Hello everyone and welcome to another predictions video. Today we are doing the Serie A 2024-2025 season. So let's get right into it. I believe 20th will be Venezia. I think their squad is not very special, to put it lightly, very uninspiring, if that's the correct term. So I think they're going straight down. I believe the same fate for Como, as though I think it'll be closer for them to stay up. I think 20th is dead set, and then anything between 13th or maybe around 12th below is going to be very relegation battle. I don't think it's going to be they're competing for Europe, but we'll see. I believe Cagliari will be 18th. They barely got out last year. Very uninspiring, like a lot of these teams between 13th and 12th, 20th, 13th and 20th, or 12th and 20th. Let's get Verona 17th. Once again, nothing special. Let's say Parma, let's not get ahead of ourselves, they're a good team, but it's going to be a lot for them to stay up, so they'll be happy with staying up. I don't think they'll push for Europe or anything just yet. I think Udinese gets 15th, I don't think they're very special. Maybe they can get out of being very bad now, we'll see. They still have that guy that they haven't sold in midfield, he rejected every big team so far. They'd get 14th, not Torino, my bad, I forget some of these teams. Lecce, I think just because of how bad it is, they'll get this high up, but like in any other year, I feel like a lot of these teams would be for relegation, but there's a lot of lower-end teams for Serie A this year. Whether that's good or bad for the league, I don't know. I think Sassuolo gets 13th. Like I said, they weren't great last year, but there's so many like unexperienced teams or squads that are just so bad, they might squeak in a mid-table finish this year. So, and I think Genoa will follow suit, squeak it out. Maybe they'll get a near mid-table finish. I think Monza will get 11th, realistically. They could push for Europe. Them and Torino, I think, will be on the boundary. Maybe Fiorentina as well. Good teams. I think Torino will get 11th. Or Torino will get 10th, my bad. And they will push for Europe quite closely, but I don't think they get it. For ninth, this is all the big teams now. I think it'll be Bologna as they're in Europe. They're gonna need to try more on that as it's their first time. They're gonna go all out in Europe, I'm pretty sure. They won't take it for granted. So I think in the table they'll slip, but in Europe they're gonna try and maybe they can get out of that Champions League group, depending what it is. You never know. So new format and everything. I think Fiorentina will get 8th. I think them and Lazio were going to battle out. Maybe they overtake Lazio since Lazio has a new coach for the third time in the last year, like Napoli's been doing. So, and Baroni, I don't know much about him. I don't know his experience, but I don't think they'll do too well. We'll see how it goes, but I think Fiorentina and Lazio will battle for the last Europa League spot, but I think Lazio will be getting it with the better squad, and maybe their manager could pull some wonders. Maybe they get up higher. I think the last Europa League spot, I'll give it to Atalanta. I guess you could say it's a bit of Napoli bias, and I'm trying not to do that, but I have to give it to Napoli here. Like, come on. But yeah, Atalanta, good squad, good coach. It's hard to put them that low. They just won the Europa League, but they're so inconsistent from year to year if you look at their finishes, or maybe I'm wrong, but I feel like they're inconsistent. They go up really high, sometimes they go really low. In like the mid-table level for them is low, so I will be going with Napoli next. I don't think they're gonna be Scudetto winners, as some of the media is trying to say, and it's not happening. But I think that Napoli will do well, or at least to like at some point in the season get them not well enough to get Champions League. But I think it'll be a rough start because Conte is gonna really pressure them. And if it goes badly for too long, you might see them slip again because they might sack Conte because they really want the results of Champions League. I think Juve gets 4th. They really messed up their transfer window, just like Napoli's doing right now. They didn't get Tabito. They're going to go for Kalulu now, who's average at best. Their defense and strikers and forwards don't look too great, but their midfield's really good, so that might help carry them through the season. So Juve, I think, will still get a Champions League spot with Mata. Maybe they'll play inspiring football instead of a Allegri ball. So I think 3rd will be Roma. I think Roma under De Rossi will do solid. They have Dybala. I think this is the time for them to make the next step, and if they don't, then you have to think, what is their ceiling? It might be just fringe top 4 at most. So I think this is their year to take a step and start pushing for the title, or getting close. With their new signings as well, they They signed Dope Bick at striker. That's a serious signing. They signed Sule and Lafie, so that's really good signings. So I respect that a lot. I think they'll push for the title or get, you know, around that Champions League spot at minimum. So good business by them. Well, guys, I actually changed my mind. Let's keep Roma there. They're going to be second with their signings. I really like them and their coach to end the last season. I think Milan's going to be third. I think them and Juve will compete for the fourth spot. So I put Milan third because their signings haven't been too great. They have their squad from last season, which is not too bad. But I think they got a coach who's not anything too far-fetched. They don't have a coach that's too special. Like, of course, it's a good thing they got rid of Pioli. But I don't know if Manesca, or however you say his name, sorry if I said it wrong, will be the answer. So I think they should get a Champions League spot for this week in Serie A. I think it's a very weak year for Serie A. So they should get a Champions League spot, at least. So I'd put them in around third or fourth. And then the winners, I have Inter Milan again. It's quite easy for me. I don't know who can compete with them. I don't see Juve competing. I don't see Napoli competing. I don't see Milan competing with them. I don't, maybe Roma, but that's really far-fetched. Their defense isn't too far improved, Roma, so I don't see it. I think Roma will be their closest opponent, to be honest, but I think Inter might run away with the league this year. But that's just my prediction, so you guys could tell me what I got horribly wrong in the comments, or how bad I disrespected your team and how little ball knowledge I have. So yeah, let me know in the comments, and hope you guys enjoyed this prediction, and we'll look next year hopefully and see how bad this was. So peace out, guys. See you in the next video.